Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Mayin Abuhan, and my chosen topic is understanding sexual orientation in maternal and child health nursing. There are some major barriers for healthcare providers when caring for individuals who are different from them. One of these barriers is the potential for personal bias. This barrier can only be addressed through self-reflection, trying to understand why these differences might bother you, and setting these feelings aside while taking care of patients. The other major barrier is language. Nurses need to know the right words to describe patients and to discuss the differences with them so that they don't feel threatened. The self-reflection, expanding knowledge, and vocabulary are the key parts of becoming a culturally competent nurse. There are three main types of sexual orientation: the heterosexual, homosexual, and bisexual. And let's move on to development of sexual orientation. Sexual orientation development refers to changes, processes, and experiences over time that can involve awareness, exploration, appraisal, commitment, integration, and communication concerning a person's identity as a sexual being, which is based on their patterns of sexual attractions and behaviors. Sexual orientation terminology for nurses. Heterosexual. A person is someone who finds sexual fulfillment with a member of the opposite gender. Homosexual. A person is someone who finds sexual fulfillment with a member of his or her own sex. Lesbian. Female-identified individuals who are sexually attracted to female partners. Gay. Male-identified individuals who are sexually attracted to male partners. MSM. Men who have sex with men. WSM. Women who have sex with women. Bisexual. People are bisexual if they achieve sexual satisfaction from both same sex and heterosexual relationship. Healthcare barriers based on sexual orientation. Although LGBT people often have demonstrated behaviors consistent with an LGBT identity from early childhood, late adolescence is the time most persons begin to identify as LGBT, and when they are ready to reveal this, healthcare providers' LGBT patients may be hesitant to reveal their sexual orientation to healthcare providers because they are often the victims of bullying, family rejections, and sexual assault. In the study, 30% of LGBT patients had a negative experiences with the healthcare provider because of their sexual orientation. Because of expected or actual discrimination in the healthcare setting, LGBT individual may enter late care and may be at increased risk for adverse health conditions, including sexually transmitted infection or STIs, or unwanted pregnancy and mental health issues. Communication related to sexual orientation. Assuming anything is a barrier to good communication when asking about a patient's need. Ask about patient's partner or partners. Once information is gathered about the gender of the patient's partner or partners, make sure to tailor education to the patient's specific needs. A nurse can build trust and ensure the individuals will return for care as needed by. Communication related to gender identity. With all the sexual identities, it is important not to make assumptions. A patient may be listed as a sex that they don't agree with on their medical chart. It is best to ask which pronoun he, she, his, or her to use. And that would be all. Thank you.